Hello and welcome everyone. My name is Meepolis and this is Literally Graphic. And today we are looking at the historical fiction graphic novel Christy Pitts by Jamie Michaels and Doug Fedra and published by Dirty Water Comics. Warning for depiction of anti-Semitism and imagery. According to their Kickstarter profile, Jamie Michaels is a Jewish Canadian writer from the mean streets of Winnipeg. He holds an MA in fiction from the University of London. And Doug Fedra is a talented Winnipeg-based illustrator who is bringing the world of Christy Pitts to life. He was educated at Red River College and has over a decade of experience in arts and design. The Kickstarter also credits Jordan Stranger, an OG Cree graphic designer that prepared the book for printing, Helen Surgener as the project editor, E.L. Michaels as project manager, and Liam Karp, quote, a Prairie Hebrew from Manitoba and a graduate from the University of Winnipeg film program. He is the project videographer and photographer, end quote. To briefly summarize this highly researched, centered around a true event, but not actually nonfiction story, let's click over to Goodreads and read it. A gritty ride through Toronto's immigrant neighborhoods, Christy Pitts tells the incredible true story of when young Jewish and Italian immigrants squared off against Nazi-inspired thugs on the streets of Toronto. This is the history of a gruff and unrecognizable Canada, one of swastika clubs and public bigotry. A homemade swastika flag flown at a public baseball game was the spark that found tinder in that untenable and hateful condition. What followed was the worst race riot in Canadian history. Archival research and firsthand interviews lend historical depth to an unknown story of resistance against hatred in uncertain times. Overall, I thought the art was a bit too busy and wordy, but still easy to follow, as not appearing to be anyone real seemed to be a major goal for this book. The characters are pretty cartoony. The book is a bit oversized. I found some of the characters looked too similar. At least it seemed as if, when we hit the flashbacks to how the family came over, the male character designs appear to be shared by some of the older male characters as they transition through the age that we find the main male character at the start of the novel. Taking things a step further than my typical comment about everything gender being very much in the binary, this book is also a bit heavy on the male representation. Not to say that the apparently cis women here were mistreated or maligned in any way. They were there, just less the focus of the story, which is fine in my opinion. And while queer people of all kinds has existed through all time and space, they are, as is often the case, not shown in this piece of historical fiction. There are, however, themes of the importance of biological, heterosexual, and monogamous family. Race, the obvious focus of the book, is represented in a way that reminds us, the reader, that many people we consider part of whiteness today were not considered part of whiteness historically. It would probably have been easy enough to just make this a Nazi versus Jewish thing, but the inclusion of the Italian-Jewish solidarity was a very good touch. That said, dialogue about or inclusion of Black and Indigenous representation would have been even nicer. Class. While not the main point of conflict in the novel, does feel well represented. The central characters are recent immigrants struggling to just live life even as anti-Semitism is rearing its ugly head in Canada. While not the only intersection not really explored in the book, disability versus ability felt like the most avoided. Perhaps I'm being a bit harsh, but it feels like it would have been pretty easy to not have everyone in the book perfectly able-bodied. But overall, I would tend to rate this title pretty highly, as so much effort clearly went into the creating of the book, and I hope this will continue a trend in very engaging and political material. While I continue to think more intersectionality would be better, I'm not totally jaded yet. 4 out of 5 stars. Bye y'all, keep reading and resist white supremacy. And as always, Literally Graphic is created on land that should be given back to the traditional landholders, which in this case is, to my knowledge, the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation, Anishinaabe people, the Haudenosaunee Confederacy, and the Huron-Wendat Nation.